Tidy-ho!
Whoa. Oh, God. Oh, why do they have to wake me up like that? Oh, what time is it? It's time for another review! Hey perverts, welcome back to another edition of Tommy Likes It. I'm your host, Tommy Purr, the man diva of indie professional wrestling here in Las Vegas, Nevada. And this episode is once again sponsored in part by Rogue Toys, who were really impressed with the first episode. And I really, really thank you guys for tuning in, subscribing, leaving comments, giving me critiques and positive feedback. The customers seemed happy, the bosses seemed happy, I was very happy, and as a result, they have graduated me up from Bob Ross figures to something a little bit more, something I can really sink my teeth into. I don't know why I did this, but you know, I'm just like, okay, yeah, something I can really sink my teeth into. So I'm very excited, and I know that you're probably excited because you've probably gathered or surmised what exactly we're going to be looking at today based on the intro, okay? You guys seem like smart cookies out there. So without further ado, what are we looking at? What has Rogue Toys provided me with this time? Well, I'm gonna tell you. They are not available in the store yet, as of this taping. I mean, by the time that this gets edited and uploaded, we may get the shipment in, but as of right now, we don't have these in store, so these are just promo items that I've been given, and I'm excited because I just saved a whole bunch of money. Now I don't have to pick them up and buy them, but it's okay because I just basically gave my paycheck back to the store and bought a whole bunch of other stuff that I have to review. But let's go ahead and take a look at the item that they gave me this time. It's not Bob Ross, but it's just as cute. We got Teebo the Ewok from the Battle of Endor. How amazing is that? The Star Wars Black Series Return of the Jedi Teebo. I am a huge Ewok fan. I know people hate the Ewoks, but I love the Ewoks. Anything cute and furry, I definitely gravitate to, which would explain a lot of my exes. Teebo is not the only one we're gonna be taking a look at today. My bosses loved how I presented the first episode, and they loved what I did, and they loved the feedback that we got from our loyal customers. They decided to give me two figures to review for this episode. Not only are we going to be looking at Teebo, we are going to be looking at Return of the Jedi, Admiral Ackbar. Yes, I am very, very excited because, I mean, come on, who doesn't love Admiral Ackbar? You're a Star Wars fan. He has one of the most iconic lines ever. Forget, Luke, I am your father. Forget, join the dark side. Forget, I love you, I know. No. It's all about,
it's a trap.
That's like the best line ever. I'm sorry, it really is. It's meme-worthy. They've parodied it on Robot Chicken. People who aren't even Star Wars fans know that line. Come on, it's amazing. All right, so let's take a look at the packaging real quick. We will open them up we will take closer looks, but for right now, let's just admire the packaging, because guys, packaging on these figures is absolutely amazing, and the customers I've spoken to are most excited for the packaging. It's got a nice forest emerald green hue right here with the illustration, which makes perfect sense. I mean, Return of the Jedi primarily took place on Endor. The whole Battle of Endor was like the focal point of that movie, and it especially pops really well for Teebo the Ewok, because hello, he's from Endor and he's a forest creature, so it just makes sense. I'm normally a loose collector, and I think I'm gonna have to keep the boxes for these figures because they're just so pretty. Like, it's very calming and clean and crisp and fresh, and I just love it. I love it. And the drawings are especially amazing. So yeah, there you go. Standard Star Wars Black Series packaging with the display window and the display window on top. For those of you who are wondering, because I know some of the figures didn't have the plastic window on the top. So there you go. And of course, they have their one or two sentence bio on the back. For Admiral Ackbar, we have, during the Battle of Endor, veteran commander Admiral Ackbar oversaw the rebel attack, coordinating with starfighter operations led by Lando Calrissian and Wedge Antilles. And then for Teebo, you have an Ewok scout. Teebo sounded the horn, summoning the Ewoks to fight the stormtroopers during the Battle of Endor. And I especially like Teebo because I actually had a teacher named Mr. Teebo, except he only had one E, not two. And he rode a, I don't want to say motorcycle, I'm pretty sure it was just a Harley Davidson. He rode a Harley, and he had the leather jacket, but he was balding here, and he had the hair on the side, and he always wore like those the pendant neckties, the silver one with the turquoise in the middle. He wasn't Native American. He was just like your scrawny white old man, and silver pendant, turquoise in the center, and like the bead straps. Yeah, I don't know what it's called, and I don't want to look it up because it's so irrelevant. But yeah, Teebo. And, like, I was a nightmare student, so, for him, because I didn't like him. And then he ended up teaching my younger sister, so when I'd have to go pick up my younger sister from school, I'd have to deal with him, and that was fun. But okay, so I know you're tired of me talking about the packaging. Let's get down to the nitty. Okay, so I know you're tired of me talking about the packaging. You want me to get down to the nitty gritty. Let's go ahead and get right to it. Let's open these bad boys up. Trigger warning for you mint on card collectors. I'm about to open these up. We're about to do some damage. Screw it. Let's do it. All right, turn away, fast forward right now, we're opening. And here is Teebo and Admiral Ackbar out of the package. And I gotta say, they are beautiful figures. They definitely live up to the packaging. Packaging's nice, the figures are nice. This overall is just a win for me. And we haven't even gotten into the details or the accessories or the articulation. So let's go ahead and dive right in. We'll take a look at Admiral Ackbar first, because I was most excited for Teebo because I just love the Ewoks. So not to say that I don't like Ackbar, because I think I made it pretty clear that I do. So we're just gonna go with him first, okay? So we're just gonna move Teebo out of the way so I don't knock him over while I'm moving my hands. So let's go ahead and take a look. Oh, wow. Just, I hope you're catching all this and the camera catches it just as well as it does in person, looking at it with the naked eye, because the detail on the paint alone is amazing. The eye looks really nice. The shading here, fantastic. Sorry for my ugly fingernails, my gosh. See, that's what happens when you paint and do art projects. I got paint and everything's still stuck to my fingernails. So here we go. Yeah, just like, look at the nostrils, the little whiskers there. And the great thing about this head, other than the shading and the wet look, is the fact that yes, we do have a slightly articulated jaw. So yes, his mouth does open up. And it does close. Now in the movies, it didn't open up that wide anyway, so we didn't need much articulation, but it's nice that they included some, right? The head doesn't really move at all. You can, it feels like it wants to move, but the collar and the shirt are a separate piece. It's definitely a vinyl piece, and it kind of hinders the articulation there, which is okay because Admiral Ackbar didn't really move his head a lot from side to side or up and down in the movies. So you're not really missing much there, right? Arms, you do have a butterfly joint if you look inside there. Yep, you have a butterfly joint right there. Of course, there's no ab crunch. Let's see here. You have a single jointed elbow. You do have a wrist pivot, so the wrist can turn and it can go up and it can go down. Let's take a closer look. The shading and the scaling of the head does translate into the forearms, and not so much on the hands, but that's okay. It's totally cool. It's nice to know that he has six fingers. I never really counted in the movie, but it's nice to learn more about the figure, learn more about the character through the figure. And here we go, more shading. Ah, that just looks so neat. That looks so badass. I love it. And then he comes with a pistol. The pistol detail is really nice. I'm glad that they didn't get lazy and just paint the whole thing black. They actually did make this metallic silver. It's really nice. It's got a nice shine to it. Very well done. Sorry, the camera's focusing. And then as you can see here, he has his little badge or medals. I can't really tell what they're supposed to be in the movie or on the figure. And then you have the belt. And I believe you could possibly take this off. I'm not going to try because they're always such a pain to get back on. But there you go. It's a very pliable vinyl. And from here, you can see that you have a thigh cut. So the thighs and legs do move from side to side. He can... Okay, it's a little stiff. But yes, he... Ooh, look at that. Admiral Ackbar can do the splits. Look at you go, fish face. Look at you go. So just like the elbows, single jointed on the knees. Does have ankle articulation, but the ankle can't go that far back because of the molding on the pants, but you can get some articulation in the front. Again, you don't really need it because Admiral Ackbar was pretty much just in his commander's chair primarily, so it's not like you really need him to do like a ballet point or a step ball change or anything like that. So, and the legs do, the calves do go side to side. So instead of like your typical boot cut where you would have, articulation cut in the center of the calf, you have it at the knee, which is nice. So does the foot move? Okay, so the feet do swivel from side to side. So that's good too. Overall, a great figure, amazing figure. I have no complaints whatsoever. The paint is amazing. The articulation is great for the character. He doesn't really do much, so you don't need him to be super flexible or super articulated. The single joint is fine on both the elbows as well as the knees. I am not complaining at all about that. And thank you, Hasbro, for not going cheap on the gun and for not painting it all one color. Thank you for actually, go ahead and focus. Thank you for actually, you know, adding some detail to it. So I appreciate that. And thank you for that little hinged jaw. It's not much. I mean, it doesn't open that much, but just enough to do something really cool and to take some nice photos and to reenact, it's a trap. So there we go. Put him over there. Does Tommy like it? Tommy definitely likes it. Tommy loves it, actually. And thank you, Rogue Toys, because I'm just so happy that I got such an awesome figure to review. Now let's take a look at Teebo. Oh my gosh. Guys, I am in love. I think this is amazing. I can't get over the shading, the detail that went into this figure. It's having a hard time focusing. We're going to move Ackbar over here. Maybe that'll help. So there we go. Oh, guys, I'm in love. I don't even know where to start. I guess first off, we'll start with the accessories. Again, thank you, Hasbro, for not chintzing out. Everything is colored appropriately. It doesn't look cheap at all. You have your little, his makeshift hammer staff with a little rock on the end, his spear, and of course, he has a tiny, tiny dagger. Come on, focus. Oh, my camera is having a hard time focusing on that. Come on. Well, you get the gist. And of course, the dagger can fit in his little holder. It's great. So let's go ahead and take out the accessories and take a closer look at the overall figure. Oh, Teebo is so cool. Now, of course, I was a little disappointed that we didn't get Wicket first, because come on, if you like Ewoks, you gotta have Wicket. Wicket should be first. But I love the size of this guy. He's clearly, I think he's gonna be bigger than Wicket. I think Wicket's gonna be maybe a little smaller based on the movie references. But that's fine with me. This guy is so cool. He has his necklace, which is a separate piece. It's not molded to the skin, which is nice. This headpiece is also a separate piece. I am not going to take it off because I have a feeling it's going to be a pain in the butt to get back on. But as you can see there, the ears do slip right into the holes there. Beautiful shading on the face. Oh my gosh, look at him. He's amazing. I love it. This headpiece is stellar. Great paint job there. I got really lucky and my figures have nice quality control. So no paint problems that I've seen. If you see any, please let me know because I'm blind to it. Single jointed elbows. Let's see here. Single jointed knees. Articulation at the ankle, of course. Let's see here. You can move it slightly. But again, you don't need to move the ankles much. The hands, slight articulation, but they do rotate around, which is nice. Same with the feet. Look at that. Goes all the way around. No problem. The lower leg does rotate around at the knee. Let's see here. I want to make sure I don't break my figure. There's the articulation. Got it. And let's see here. Waist articulation, which is nice. Look at this. He's going dance. Oh yeah, shimmy for me, Teebo, shimmy for me. And then he does not have butterfly joints, he just has regular arm joints here, or shoulder joints. So yeah, there you go. I don't want to break him. It feels a little stiff on this figure trying to move his arms outward, so just be very careful. Again, I don't think you'll need to do much with that. It seems like there might be some hindrance with the molding on the back here, so just be very careful, you guys, okay? And the head does rotate, but it is kind of a snug fit due to the necklace and the straps and the headpiece. So again, just be very careful, okay? There you go. I don't want to break my figure. No. There you go. And of course, the straps, you can slide this off really easily. So I'm not going to because I love it, so there's no need for me to take it off. But for you customizers out there, you can easily just take these off. So you won't have to cut them or anything, which is always nice. And I didn't check on Ackbar. Did he have waist articulation? It feels like Ackbar does as well. We're going to look under his shirt. Yeah, he does. So Ackbar has waist articulation as well, but because of his little tunic, you can't really move him. It's a hindrance. But again, you don't need to because Ackbar really didn't move that much. So there we go. Yeah, does Tommy like Teebo? Tommy loves Teebo. Not his third grade teacher, the Ewok. So he's just super good. Hold it like this so we can focus better. The shading, the articulation, the accessories, everything about this figure is amazing. So if you are lucky enough to get this figure, especially from Rogue Toys, Rogue Toys will have this figure on sale for $23.99, as well as Ackbar. Both will be $23.99 when they come out. Right now, I believe we are still accepting pre-orders for both figures. And if I were you, I would definitely pre-order now. And the reason being is because I've had a lot of calls from customers wanting to know if we have these two in stock yet, especially Teebo and... All right, never mind, not especially, both of them equally. Everyone seems to be equally interested in both figures. So if you're in the store when they come out and you see both of them, pick them up. If we have the pre-orders still available at Rogue Toys, which we should, pre-order them. Pre-order them now because these will go fast. I guarantee it. The box is wonderful. It catches your eye brilliantly, and the figures will make you stay. And if you are not a Star Wars Black Series figure collector, chances are you will be after this particular series. And I can't wait to see the other figures in this wave, because if they are just as good as these two, then, oh my god, my wallet is gonna hate me. So yeah, there we go. Let me know what you guys think in the comments. Let me know if you're gonna pick up both figures. Let me know if you prefer one or the other. Or let me know if you think they suck and you think I'm blind and have no taste. You can let me know that stuff. Everyone has an opinion, so share it. And that concludes another edition of Tommy Likes It, hosted by yours truly, Tommy Purr. I want to take the opportunity to thank Rogue Toys for providing me with the wonderful products you saw tonight. I can't wait to add these guys to my Star Wars shelf. They look amazing. I also want to thank Hasbro, even though they're probably not watching this. I'm small potatoes, whatever. Thank you, Hasbro, for making wonderful toys. So many of us enjoy these things, and it's nice to, like, relive our childhoods, right? Am I right? I'm right. And finally, thank you guys for tuning in. I appreciate you taking the time out of your schedule to just watch me talk about things that I love and things that I hope you love as well. If you like what you saw, hit subscribe, leave me a comment, share with your friends. You never know. These videos are meant to tell you what to expect when you're expecting. No, not when you're expecting children. I mean, what to expect when you're expecting them toys to hit them shelves. If you liked what you saw and you're a first-time watcher, first-time subscriber, you can follow me on Instagram at @the_man_diva. You can follow me on Twitter under Rare Form, @RAWR_form. And if you look hard enough, you can find me on Facebook. And as always, you can always find me at the Rogue Toys West location in Las Vegas. That's on Rainbow, just between O'Bannon and Sahara. And we have two other locations in Las Vegas as well, Eastern and Hacienda, and downtown across the street from Pawn Stars. And if you're in Salt Lake City, we have a location there, and we also have a location in Portland, Oregon. So come on in and see us. Place an order at RogueToys.com. Try and see if those pre-orders are still available for Ackbar and Teebo. And more importantly, just have fun, you guys. They're toys, and we're all collectors, and we're all kids at heart. And that's all that matters, right? Make wise choices out there, guys, and stay safe. Hold on one second. Hello? Yeah, this is Tommy. Hi. Oh, you're calling about my car warranty.
It's a trap!